It is Absolute Radio. Here we are. We're backstage, and the Prodigy are here.
Do you want that?
Good to see you.
Hey.
Nice to see you. You're back at the Isle of Wight Festival.
Yeah, man.
It's been
2 years.
2 years or yeah. 3 years, something like that. Clearly,
2006.
So three years. Yeah. All kind of blend into one, don't they? Really. Yeah. Clearly, a festival you like doing, because there's lots of festivals to choose from now.
That's right. Yeah. Yeah.
We do them all.
Yeah, definitely growing. You know.
Country and Western next week.
Everything.
I mean, we're lucky, you know, we do anything from Download, Isle of Wight, all the way through to Gatecrasher. So, we're lucky because, we can spread ourselves from, one type of festival to another. So, we seem to...
Is that because it's very difficult to pigeonhole the kind of music that you make?
I think, when the night time comes, I think the Prodigy is the band that people associate with just the night time. So I guess, party people come out and... It's a good time for this band then, so yeah, that's the way I think about it anyway.
How have these live events changed over the last sort of 15 years? Are they better organised now? Are they worse organised now? Is it sort of still chaos?
That's always mayhem, I think that, it's our job to cause the mayhem, so if it's all nice and tidy, we want to mess it up. So that's the way we sort of do it, we don't really get involved with that. We just want to turn up and bang it, and that's what we do.
How has touring changed though over the last sort of 15 years for the band? Is it different now? Is there more stuff that you got to take with you? Is it easier?
We enjoy it more now, I think. Do you know what I mean? We're kind of professional now, aren't we? We know what we're doing. I think, we've got, right. we kind of honed it down. We travel with the same people we've had for the last 15 years, and so we've got a good team around us. Do you know what I mean? And we love it. That's the main thing.
We always bring our own sound, extra, own lights and so forth. Do you know what I mean? And it's important to have a good team around you.
Do you take family with you when you go on tour? When you go on tour, some of these tours can last 2-3 years. I mean, it can be sort of you around. I suppose
we don't tour for 2-3 years.
No, but some bands do, and I can see how they kind of lose their sort of reality.
Touring, we treasure it. Do you know what I mean? And obviously, our friends and family come out to certain shows, like tonight and so forth. But when we do long tours, like to, really stay focused on the tour and kind of really get into it. So,
how do you stay sort of emotionally and physically in shape for not just a show like this, but when you go out on tour? Because it's demanding. The kind of energy that you put into your performance, you don't see from many, to use a better phrase, dance acts. Yeah.
Doing the show actually keeps you in shape. Working out and so forth. Personally, I don't work out in the week or anything like that. Do you know what I mean? But actually doing a show keeps you in shape. So it's kind of like doing it for so long, you just tune into being in that way, when it comes to doing shows.
That's it from Keith.
Well, you're like charged, you get out there and if you've got 60,000 people shouting at you and, you're just charged, it don't matter how you feel, massive hangover or, it's your best day for, for a month. You get out there and bang it. That's why people love being in bands. It's just a drug. When you get out there, it's unexplainable. There's nothing stopping you. And it you thrive off the crowd and the crowd, you spit it back again. And that's just what happens,
Do you still enjoy playing the hits? Do you feel obliged to play the hits when you're playing a festival like this?
No, I don't think we're obliged to play anything. We just hone a track down and a set down and just when it's working, it's working. And that's, things come out and new tracks go in and, especially having the new album out and, an album that was predominantly written for going live, it means that the set is mainly all the new tracks and people are up for them over and above what you might call the old tracks.
But we still buzz off doing Smack My Bitch at Firestarter, Breathe, we still buzz on doing those tracks. If we didn't, they wouldn't be in the set.
Talk me through the buzz or the energy that you do get when you play a song. For me, Firestarter, I was at college then. I mean, when I remember first hearing that record and it literally made my blood sort of boil in my own skin. It was just an incredibly evocative and emotive piece of music. And if I feel like that, God knows how you must feel playing it live up on stage in front of all those people. Put it into words if you can.
Well, we've played it so many times, but it's a track we still love playing. But I mean, Smack My Bitch Up is the Prodigy anthem in my mind, you know what I mean? Without a doubt. We love playing it and we always will,
What is your little boy? What does your family think of the kind of music that you play? How old is he?
Ace, he's five.
Five. So yeah. Does he know what daddy does?
Of course he does. Yeah, he knows all the lyrics. Especially Smack My Bitch Up.
All the lyrics. Okay, yeah. the edited version.
Love Rick Manoel.
You know, it's the same with the music and all aspects of the Prodigy. You know, as soon as too much of the same thing becomes boring. Mm. That's why there's not always vocal tracks on the album. That's why it's, you know, one track can be vocal, one can be, like a sample track, and one can just be like an instrumental. We keep the freedom. That's, you know, it's like everything that you're asking us here about, you know, what's it like to do, you know, a certain sort of festival, or, you know, it's almost like I always feel like the band's always been running around, and just as someone feels they can pin something on us, we're gone. And we're somewhere else. You know?
I think we always knew that the latest album was going to do well. You've got a tremendously loyal fan base, but Invaders Must Die did probably even better than you had expected. Maybe?
I don't know. I think, you know, halfway through the writing process, you know, once the album was taking shape, we all kind of like, in a way, looked at each other and went, this is going to be good. This is, you know, this is what it's got to be.
Yeah, I mean, all you can hope for is, you know, you're happy with the records you come out the studio with. You don't know, and really after it leaves the studio, as long as you're happy with it and you know you delivered, that's all that really matters. You know, it's out of your hands. But yeah, we knew we had a good one. We knew the fans would like it. But it's crossing over to the outside and spreading the word of the music outside the box. You know what I mean?
I mean, we weren't going to leave the studio until we were 100% happy with the album. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? So. It just happened that we finished it in time.
To take us live. Yeah, it was a vehicle to take us live. You know, to be quite honest, it weren't like we needed a successful album. You know, we just needed banging tracks that we could put on the stage and know that we could, you know, get ourselves back out there and, you know, with new tracks and keep the live show, you know, which is so precious to us. That's everything that it's about, you know.
Did it get the old creative juices flowing that there is probably another album behind this one almost ready to go? You're thinking about
think
the next.
We don't, we, you know, we're looking at the next, you know, next few, you know, next few gigs and no further.
Exactly. Do you know what I mean? We don't look that far. Do you know what I mean? We've just started this album. Mm. Just started touring the summer festivals, and that's what our focus is, just taking around the festivals. And
that's it. You literally live sort of album to album. There is no long-term plan, and you look
no,
at the energy
at
that you...
Day to day, do you know what I mean?
There never was at the beginning, you know, someone said, oh, you might get a year out of it right at the start.
Yourselves.
Yeah, enjoy yourselves. It will last a year, and we're like, yeah, okay, well, we're still living that first year, do you know what I mean? You know, I still feel the same as I did 10 years ago.